Welcome, let's take a look at our new features related to wall styles. Upon first using an AEC command, the program offers the possibility to choose which styles to include. You can select the default ones already included in the menu at the top left, or choose from those listed in the white box. The FAM files are collections of styles offered by our program. It is also possible to import styles from a specific DWG file by pressing the Browse button. By pressing Import, the styles and units are imported. Otherwise, by selecting Skip, only the default styles are kept. On the left, you can see all the imported styles. Now we will choose one and take a look at the elements that characterize it, focusing on the most significant features. In the second tab, Component, the wall components, meaning the various layers that make it up, are listed. Each component has specific properties. Let's now look at the most significant ones. The priority defines the precedence of wall components at intersections, allowing the program to identify similar ones. Width specifies the thickness of the wall component. When a specific value is indicated, in this case 18, the width remains fixed every time this wall style is used. However, if the variable BW, base width, is used, it is possible to use different values each time. Edge offset indicates the component's position within the wall, relative to the wall baseline and adjacent components. Baseline is a user reference line used as the justification for the wall, and it can be placed anywhere within the wall, not necessarily at the start or end. As with the width, you can assign a precise value, 0 corresponds to the baseline, or indicate a formula that includes the base width, BW. In this image, we can clearly see that, in the absence of an offset, the component is adjacent to the baseline, whereas on the right, the component is shifted by a value equal to the offset. Bottom elevation and top elevation define the vertical offset of the component, measurable from the following reference points: wall top, base height, baseline, or wall bottom. Now, let's look at the display properties that define how each component is represented in the display representation. For each component, you can modify the display properties, and to do so, the style override checkbox must be checked. Now, let's try modifying the model representation, which is the visualization style of the 3D part. A window opens with the list of all components, which are called boundaries, and for each of them, we modify the representation color. Now let's modify the plan view, which is the 2D visualization. We activate the display of the hatch for the third component and change its color. Moving to the second tab, we can modify the type of hatch pattern. The angle. And the orientation, which can be global for the world coordinate system or entity, which aligns the hatch to the object itself regardless of the object's rotation. Let's insert a wall using the style we just modified. It's possible to see the result of our choices already in the style selection preview, and by changing the view, it's possible to see the hatch pattern. Let's now create a new wall style. The example we'll use is this 6-layer wall. Note that the measurements are in centimeters, but we will enter them in millimeters as the units set in our drawing. First, we enter the name of our style and a brief description. We then proceed with adding each component. Let's remember a few characteristics. The name will group the same elements on specific CAD layers, which is useful for custom views or rendering. And priority defines the precedence at intersections. We enter the width, which in this case is fixed. We set the offset to 0, making it the baseline, which is the reference point for the other components. Now we add the second component. And in this case, the width also has a fixed value. Let's focus on the offset. While we previously set it to 0, now we set it to 10, which is the width of the first layer. This way, the two layers are positioned one after the other. Now, let's insert the third component. Note that in this case, the width is variable. This way, the width of the layer can be modified when inserting a wall of this style. The offset for this component is given by the sum of the widths of the previous components. Let's insert the fourth component. In this case, the width is also fixed. Let's focus on the offset. Since it is the sum of the widths of the previous components, it is not a fixed value, but depends on the variable WD. We then finish creating the style by adding the remaining components. Let's now compare the newly created style with another identical one where a different component, located in the middle of the wall, was chosen as the baseline. This means there are both positive and negative offsets. Note, to have negative values, it is necessary to multiply BW by -1. Now, let's modify some display properties, activate some hatches, and change their colors. We then insert a wall using the newly created style. As you can see, the color changes are already visible in the preview. In the style definition, we included a formula that incorporated the base width, allowing the width to be modifiable.